The sun was rising slowly over Calvary Circus. It was Thursday morning, the day of the big show, and everyone was still sleeping soundly. Everyone, that is, except for Jeremy. He was too worried to sleep. After 3 days of rehearsals, Jeremy still hadn't found his talent. The clowns, the strong guys, and all the other circus stars had been very kind to him, but he still didn't feel like he belonged. Jeremy was afraid that he would let the circus down, so while everyone was still asleep, he packed his suitcase and decided to leave Calvary Circus.
Well, that's the last of it. I hope they have a good show without me. This was all just another big failure.
Jeremy!
Oh, Barnaby!
What are you doing?
Nothing, just, you know, taking a stroll and just walking everywhere.
Are you leaving?
Leaving what? No. No, I'm not leaving.
Come on over here, son. Have a seat. Tell me, what's going on?
I know this is going to sound really lame, Barnaby, especially after everyone's been so nice to me, but I just don't feel like I belong here.
Why is that?
Well, all my life I've just felt a little bit lonely. And when I came to the circus, I thought it was my big chance to fit in. But I still have that feeling of emptiness, and I can't get rid of it.
Well, that's because we're all born with loneliness in our hearts, Jeremy. You remember when I told you that we're all born sinners?
Yeah.
Well, worst thing about sin is that it separates us from God. I mean, we were created to be friends with God, but our sin keeps us apart from Him. That's why you're lonely. You were created to know God, but you've never met Him personally.
So it's not about me fitting in?
Not at all. The most famous movie star in the world is just as lonely as you are. But see, that hole in your heart, that can only be filled with the love of Jesus. But you can try to fill it with fame or money or a fancy job, but none of that's going to fix a broken heart. The only thing that's going to fix a broken heart, my friend, is the love of Jesus Christ.
But, Barnaby, how can I have that love if I'm a sinner? Oh, wait, I think you told me yesterday. You said that God sent His only Son to die for my sins, right?
Yes, I did. For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in Him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Thank you, Lord.
Yeah, you said that He sent His only Son to die for me. You said that He rose again from the dead so that I could know God.
Yep. Almost as importantly, He put all those promises in the Bible for us to remember.
Wow. Why would He do that, Barnaby?
You really want to know?
Yeah, please tell me.
So you could belong to Him, Jeremy. Wait a minute. I got an idea. There's a parable in the Bible that explains the whole thing beautifully.
All right.
Let's see if we can get some early risers over here. Looks like everybody's half dead. Hey, wake up, everybody. Come on. Need some help out here. Come on. Let's move it.
Morning, Barnaby.
Good morning, good morning. Want to act out a Bible story?
Oh, okay.
Can you give us a hand?
Sure.
Okay, why don't you grab some costumes?
Okay.
Now, we're going to be in Matthew, and we're doing 13, 25, and 26.
Okay.
Okay,
oh, I like that.
You got that one? Okay. And, wait a minute, there's a Bible over there. Why don't you grab that Bible? Oh, let me put my glasses on.
I'm in Philippians. Am I close?
Philippians? No. You went past, my friend. Here you go. Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Okay. Matthew 13. Here we go.
45. There it is. All right. Is everyone almost ready? Getting your costumes on here.
Wait for me.
Okay, I'm sorry.
I couldn't find something.
Okay, we're waiting.
Here, I'll get that. There we go.
Thanks.
And poofy shoulders.
You got it?
All right.
Okay, now I'm ready. Now,
read it out loud.
Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant seeking beautiful pearls, who, when she had found one of great price, went and sold all that she had and bought it.
Pearls, pearls, pearls to sell. Great big beautiful pearls. Oh my goodness, look at that pearl. It's the most beautiful pearl I've ever seen. Oh, how much is it?
1,000,000 shekels.
1,000,000 shekels? I don't have that much money. Oh, 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 but don't sell it. Don't sell it. I will find a way to get the money. Okay, have to find a way to get the money. Have to find a way to get the money. Oh, what am I gonna do?
Who, when she had found one pearl of great price, went and sold all that she had and bought it.
Okay, 1,000,000 shekels. How am I gonna get 1,000,000 shekels? Oh, oh, I can sell my house! House for sale! Beautiful house for sale! It's a great neighborhood! Newly redone bathrooms! Oh, oh, great! Thank you so much! This is a wonderful start! Okay, okay. Let's see, what else? What else do I have? Oh, my furniture! Furniture for sale, handcrafted! Oh, great, thank you! Thank you so much! Oh, enjoy it! Oh, this is wonderful! Okay, oh, we're getting closer. Okay, what else do I have? What else? What else can I sell? Okay, well, maybe she'll take this. Okay, I still need a little more. Okay, what else do I have? What else do I, oh, my ring, clown ring, yeah. Oh, it's perfect for you. Oh, let's see. Oh, well, I'm still a little short. Well, I'm running out of things to sell. What else am I gonna sell? Clown shoes for sale. Oh, oh, good. Oh, oh, no. Thank you. Oh, thank you. Okay. Oh, I did it. 1,000,000 shekels. And a banana.
Banana.
I did it. I have the money. 1,000,000 shekels and a banana.
Wow, you must really want this pearl.
Oh, I do. I do. I sold everything I own. It's so, so special to me. Thank you.
Jeremy, the reason Jesus told this parable was to give us an insight into the kingdom of heaven. You see, Jeremy, you are that pearl. And he wanted you so much that he gave his very best. He gave his life so that you could belong to him.
Forever and ever?
Mm-hmm. Forever and ever.
Well, I want to belong to him right now. How do I tell him?
Well, you just ask. You pray, and you ask him to take ownership of your life.
Oh, can we do that right now? I don't want to waste another second.
Sure. Come on, let's kneel down. Let's pray. I want you to repeat after me, okay?
All right.
Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
I know that I'm a sinner.
I know that I'm a sinner.
I know that I've broken God's laws.
I know that I've broken God's laws.
But I want you to belong to me. I want to belong to you.
And I want to belong to you.
And know you like a friend.
And know you like a friend.
Please forgive my sins and cleanse my heart.
Please forgive my sins and cleanse my heart.
Fill me with your Holy Spirit.
And fill me with your Holy Spirit.
And make me a child of God.
And make me a child of God.
Thank you, Lord, for dying on the cross.
Thank you, Lord, for dying on the cross.
And paying the price so that I could know you.
And for paying the price so that I could know you.
Be my Lord and my God.
Be my Lord and my God.
In Jesus' name, Amen.
And in Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Wow. I belong to Jesus now. I belong to Jesus now. How exciting is that?
It's so exciting. Welcome to the family, Jeremy. Hey,
family?
Well, sure. I mean, when you give your heart to Jesus, you become part of the family of God.
Awesome. I got a family, too? This can't get any better.
Does that mean you're not leaving us anymore?
Leaving? No, I can't leave. We have a show to put on.
All right.
but sorry to be a downer, but you don't have a talent.
Oh,
I kind of need that.
Well, I mean, I could always be a clown again.
No,
And not tell any jokes or do any stunts.
I have an idea. What if we pray and ask God to show you what to do?
Oh, that's a great idea. All right, here we go. Dear God, I want to be a helper. Please help me find my talent so that I can be in the circus tonight. And in your name I pray. Amen.
Amen. All right. Any ideas?
Not yet. I can't be a clown.
It's an emergency!
What's the matter, Sister Candy? What's wrong?
The people are going to be here in 10 minutes.
Okay.
And no one can find the ringmaster.
He's gone! What are we gonna do?
I looked everywhere. I found his hat and his cape, but I couldn't find him.
What are we gonna do?
Guys, I know my talent. Guys, I found my talent.
I
can help organize the show until he gets back.
You can?
Yeah. Claudia, can you please go check the sound equipment? Amanda, you and Barnaby, can you go take tickets, please? Come on, guys. Clueless. Never mind. Bananas. Here. Come on, bananas.
No. We gotta go.
Thank you. Okay. You see this? No. Don't eat it. No. No eating it. All right. You see this? Ringmaster. I need you to go find the ringmaster. You ready? Go find ringmaster. Go get him, bananas. Go. All right. Come on, guys. We got a show to put on.
Jeremy was so busy helping that he didn't realize how peaceful he felt in his heart. Before he knew Jesus, something like this would have filled him with worry. But today, his heart was full of joy, like Paul and Silas, and strength, like King David. He was a new man.
All right, Jeremy, we're all ready. You're doing great. Okay, here's the ringmaster's clipboard and the microphone.
All right, thanks. I guess let's get this thing started. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to the most entertaining enterprise on this side of Chester County. Are you guys ready to have a good time? All right, then put your hands together for the one, the only, Calvary Circus! Calvary Classical Dancers. Now put your hands together for the sillier side of our spectacular show, the funniest clowns on this side of the continent, Claudia, Chicky, and Clueless.
Thank you.
you, clowns. Now prepare yourselves to see the mightiest men ever to cross the Calvary Circus stage. Our very own strong guys led by Herbert the Boy Wonder! Issued a challenge. Would anyone in our audience over there like to face him in tug of war? You sir, come on up. Come on up. Come on up.
Oh no.
Very impressive. Very impressive. Now, you've seen the spectacular strongmen, you've seen the crazy clowns, and you've even seen the delightful dancers. Now prepare yourselves to see our amazing acrobats. Get ready for the world's most flexible family, the Flying Zucchinis! I like your pajamas.
Oh, hi. I guess I set my alarm for 7. Oh no, it must have been PM instead of AM.
Oh, dude.
So, who woke you up?
You don't want to, what you?
Hey guys.
You know,
no. Hey guys, I found my trumpet. And there's a monkey here.
That's a gorilla. That's a gorilla. Good job, bananas. High five.
Well, it stinks you missed the show, Mr. Ringmaster, but it was in really good hands.
It was?
Andy ran the whole show. He did awesome.
He did?
Yeah, and I did something even better this morning, Mr. Ringmaster. I gave my life to Jesus, and I finally understand why God had me come to the circus. I thought it was just so that I could fit in and I could prove myself by being strong or funny or athletic, but I instead learned that God loves me just for me. And once I learned that, My whole day changed. I mean, he died and rose again so that my sins could be forgiven and I could live with him forever. And my whole day changed after that. I was actually going to leave this morning, but I know, but God gave me the strength and the joy to finish the day out strong.
Well, that sounds like a reason to celebrate. And celebrate we shall. Since I was just a wee bit late, I stopped by Calvary Bakery and got cookies. Come on.
I'm so hungry. I can eat two dinners right now.
Here. My goodness. Oh, well. Hey, did you enjoy the show?
Yeah!
Wasn't it awesome when Jeremy asked Jesus into his heart?
Yeah.
And when he did that, he became a Christian and part of the family of God, which means he gets extra special protection and watch care. He gets to go to heaven and be with Jesus someday. That is so cool. Have you ever asked Jesus into your heart?
Yeah!
Oh, good. I'm glad to hear that. And if you haven't, the best time to do it would be now because it's important and it's easy. You know, just like Jeremy learned, yeah, he had to admit it. He was a sinner, and we're all sinners, and we all need Jesus. The Bible says that for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes on him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Yeah, hopefully everybody learned that this week. And it also says in Romans that while we were yet sinners, when we were still sinners, Christ died for us. But after he died, the great thing is he overcame sin and death, and he rose on the third day, the resurrection, and then he went out and he hung out with his friends and his disciples, and that was so neat. God loves each and every one of you so much that he sent his Son to die for you on a cross so that he could have a relationship with you, and he wants to have that. And that's easy, just through prayer and accepting Jesus into our hearts. So if you want to make that prayer tonight, we can do that together. I've done it before, but I'm going to say the prayer again. So if everyone would just please close your eyes, bow your heads, and repeat after me. Dear Jesus, thank you for loving me. I know that I'm a sinner, and I need you to be my Savior. Please forgive me for my sins. Please come into my heart. And show me how to live for you. In Jesus' name, amen. That's wonderful. And if you've prayed that prayer, then that means you're a Christian and part of the family of God. And if tonight was the first time that you've ever prayed that prayer, or it was really special to you, I want you to make sure you tell your leader all about it, because they've prayed that prayer, and they want to help you, encourage you, and answer any questions you might have. All right, have a great night. Good night.